Hi guys, TB here. In this video I want to show you how to install and use the Revolution Multimedia Gallery. So, when you download the files from Code Canyon, you will receive something like this zip file. The name might be different, but inside it there is this zip file fwdrmg. So this is the actual plugin that you need to install here. So I'll just replace it because I already have it on the desktop. And now go to add new, upload plugin, choose file, install now. It's a very simple process. The plugin is installed, and then on the left you will see this submenu. So it has three sections. It has the general settings, which is used to configure the gallery. For example, remove buttons, change the display type, add all kind of stuff like using drag, spacing between buttons. This is the menu window settings for the menu. Let me open this to show you. Here I have here a local test of this. So this is the menu. So you can work here on the menu to show it, hide it, and all kind of stuff. This is a share window settings for the share window here. This is the thumbnail settings here at the bottom, these thumbnails. And caption settings, which is this caption here. And the video player settings for the video and audio player that it's used inside the player, this one. So I will I'll return to this in later in this video, but for now remember that this is used to set up the gallery, change certain aspect of the aspects of the gallery. Now the galleries manager allows to add as many galleries as you want. So what I mean by galleries, you can see when I open the menu here, we have a mixed gallery and then we have an audio and video gallery. And then an iframe and HTML gallery. So you can add as many galleries as you want using this this galleries manager, which I'll show you shortly how it's used. And then the CSS editor. This is the some of the CSS classes that are used for the plugin. So let's get back to general settings. So by default, this is working with presets. So there is a default preset which can be used as the default preset for the gallery, but this preset cannot be modified. So if you want to use this, you'll have to use it with the default settings. If you want to have, of course, you'll want to work with the preset that can be updated. Just on the preset name, just add here a name. I'll call it my preset, and then add new preset. And now if you look here, you see there is an update preset and also a delete preset. So if I refresh the page, the default it's shown first, but you can select it from here. So by default, right now I'll just leave it as it is. I will not change anything. I'll come back and show you a few things here after I create a gallery. So for the gallery manager, let's add a main gallery. Gallery one, I'll call it, and I'll call this one. I'll just call it gallery one again. So now we have a main gallery, and these are basically the categories that I showed you here. So these are categories, sub galleries, I don't know how to call them. So now we will actually create a gallery, a sub gallery in the main gallery, and here we can add the items. So I'll just add a new item. I'll show you some of the formats here. I'll just show you first the image. We add here, this is the image source. Actually, let me walk you through this dialogue. So this is the name. This will not appear anywhere, just for reference for you to know that it's here. The item source can be images, videos, iframes, Google Drive, YouTube, Vimeo, HTML content, Google Maps embeds. I'll walk you through some of the most important ones. The thumbnail path represents the path of the thumbnail. If you want to use thumbnails, please note that all items has to have a thumbnail. If some of them, if one of them is missing a thumbnail, then these thumbnails will not appear here. So remember this if you want to use thumbnails. The item maximum width and item maximum height applies to, for example, to the video element. Right now we have this width and this height. This can be changed individually here for each item, or you can just set it globally in the, I'll just have this open here, in here, see, default item width and default item height. This is in pixels. All these numbers here are in pixels. So if by default the gallery will use this maximum width and maximum height for the video, iframe, anything that is not an image basically. But if you want to change this individually for the item, you can do it here. Okay, the video poster pad, this is just for video. It can be added from the library or from an external source. This applies to the thumbnail part and also item source. It doesn't have to be from the library, it can be from anywhere. Just copy and paste here the path, for example something like this, and it will work just fine. Video subtitle, if you have a video subtitle, it's an SRT file. I will, in the documentation you'll find the download link to see how the subtitle is formatted if you want to use it. The video thumbnails preview refers to this. Let me see if I can find it here. Subtitles, thumbnails preview, okay. So you see, when I hover the main scrubber, these thumbnails will, these live preview thumbnails will appear here. So you can just add here, there is an explanation. If you want to use auto, so the, so this way the thumbnails are generated automatically from the video, just add here auto, like this. And you can also use a VTT file. Again, there will be a link in the documentation for this to see how it works. The VTT file allows to create manually these thumbnails. You can create your own VTT, because for example for Vimeo and YouTube is not possible to use automatically generated thumbnails. This is the Vast VMAP or IMA SDK URL. If you want to use Vast or this at Google AdSense stuff, just add the URL here. And this is the private video password if you want to use a private password. And here this is the caption. So what appears here is the caption. I'll go through this, through some of, all of them in a moment. So let's delete this and let's add an image. Image. And I'll just choose an image from here. You see it has, it's a large image. Also add the thumbnail. Now the thumbnail, I already created them. My advice is to use the thumbnails, to save the thumbnails height the same as here. So right now it's 80 pixels. Again, these are pixels. You can, all of these, the most complicated or harder to understand options have these tooltips that are explaining how they work. So my advice to have the gallery that loads fast and performs better, especially on mobile devices, please save your thumbnails images as at this height. For example, it's 80 pixels. So now 18 pixels, sorry. So now if you see, this has an 18 pixels height, and the width, it doesn't really matter, the width it's calculated automatically. So let's add a thumbnail. For the image I'll leave everything blank except the caption. So this is the template for the caption. I'll just copy this, I'll paste it, and just replace inside the tags the title, for example. So I'll just call, I'll call this image title and image description. Okay, now these two classes here, you see these two classes, the title class and the desk class. These classes are formatting the title and the description. So these classes can be found in the CSS editor. I will just copy this one, for example, and paste it, and let's go here. So the caption can be at the outside at the bottom of the item, inside the item at the bottom, or inside the item at the top. So in this case it's outside, so we need to find the bottom caption, bottom in, top in, top in. Let me see. So it's the this default, you see, caption out. So here we can change, for example, the for the A tag, the color and the all the other stuff that you want to change. Here is the font, see, and I'll show you in a moment how this works. So let's just have an image here for now. So we have a main gallery with a sub gallery with an image, and also we have a preset here. Okay, so let's go into a page and edit it. I already have the shortcut here, but I will delete it. And in the page tab here, you'll see the shortcut generator, and select from the select boxes the preset and the gallery. It's already here. If more galleries are added in the galleries manager, more galleries will appear here. Okay, add it here and preview. And now we have a gallery with a single image, and here is the caption. So for example, let's change the color of the caption, of the title, to red. So this is the description and this is the title, and I'll just change the color here to red. Update CSS and work. You see, let's change the title. And here you can also change the, for example, the font size. I'll just make something bigger to 20 pixels. Actually, I've modified the description, I'm sorry. Caption title, okay, let's make this bigger. Now set this back to, I think it was 14 pixels. And this one to 30 pixels. See, there is a huge title and a small description. So this is how it works. Of course, you can change the colors, line, height, anything you want in this. I will just close this for now. So we have an image. Let's add more here to general settings, and let's go here to playlist, galleries manager, sorry. And let's add the video. And this is a video MP4. I already have this here. And now I will add it from the library. Again, you can add it from any location as long as the path is returning, the URL is returning a video path. Okay. So for the thumbnail path, I already have, I think I have the, not this one, I think this one. Say it's 18 pixels again. And let's also add the poster, which I already have created. The poster size doesn't really matter. Just make sure that it's a good quality. And add item. I will just move it down here. Let's add, I don't know, YouTube, for example. So I'll just go here to YouTube. Just select any video that you want and copy the URL from the top. Paste it here. In this case, I will not add a poster or a caption. I'll move it down here. Ah, I forgot to tell you, these are sortable, so you can just change the order as you want, and they will be reflected in the gallery. So now the items will be displayed from the top to the bottom. Let's add Vimeo as well. For Vimeo again. Just add the Vimeo. Just go to the video, copy the URL and paste it here. And again, I will not add a caption here. I'll move it down. MP3, I will not add. Actually, let me add an MP3 as well. So for audio files, just select the, I don't know if I have here an MP3 file, to be honest. Actually, I do. And for this one again, you can add a poster, but I don't know what the thumbnail, I'm sorry, first. again, 18 pixels, and also a poster. I will show you why we need a poster here. Okay, let me update this to be sure I will not lose it. And let's test to see how this looks. So I think I forgot to add a thumbnail to some of this. Let me see. So this is having a thumbnail. This is having a thumbnail. This does not have a thumbnail. So for YouTube, we need to add a thumbnail. This one. And I think I forgot to add from Vimeo as well. Yeah. Not you. Let me see for MP3. So now you see all the thumbnails are here, and from the multimedia display button appears here. Of course, this doesn't have a caption. Thumbnail. And let's add, for example, for the video here, let's add the auto-generated thumbnail. So go down and just add here auto. Now when I test it, you will see sorry about that, there was a small cache issue there. So now if I play this, you will see the auto-generated thumbnails here. So let's, since I am here, let me go back to here and also add a password, or just add the password of Melly. Now when I refresh this and play it, you see that this requires a password, and if I type the wrong password, it will not work. And Melly, it's working fine. Please remember that this is working for YouTube, I mean the password, it's working for YouTube. This is from YouTube. This is from Vimeo. Anything that it's Vimeo, anything that is video, it will work just fine, including for MP3 files as well. See? Okay, what's next here? So to let's add an iframe as well. For iframe, just copy the iframe page, the page that you want to use for this one, and add it as an item source. And for the thumbnail, I think this one, yes, I will leave it this as it is. Okay, and let's test. And you see, this is the page, and it has a scroll bar, exactly like one iframe works. And the last one that I want to show you, it's for HTML content. For HTML content, we need to first add here the HTML content. And these names are not important. And for the source, you need to, we have to add here the ID of the, basically the element that is containing the content that you want to display. So I'll just add a test here. And let me add on thumbnail as well. And now in the page we have to create this. So just, of course, this can be done, doesn't have to be added here in the editor, but I will show you because this is the most easiest way for me to show you this. Widget, custom HTML. Okay, so I'll create here a div, and I'll give it an ID of test, exactly like we have added it there. And again, I will close it, and here I'll add the p tag, and I'll add the style to it. I'll change the color to white. I am HTML content p. So let's update and see if, I hope I did not forget anything here. See, it's displaying the content. Now here you can, inside this div, So only what's inside this div is displayed, not this div itself. So anything that inside here, it will be displayed. Then you can style it as you want via CSS. It doesn't have to be inline CSS. It can be added here in the CSS editor or your own CSS files. So this is how we add the gallery. Now, as you noticed, there is no menu because we have just a gallery. So when a single gallery is added in a main gallery, the menu will be automatically disabled because there is no point to show it a single gallery. So let's create a new one and I'll call it gallery 2. And let's move it down again. Also, the galleries are sortable. Add a new item. I will just add an image here, a simple image with this something else. This girl. No thumbnails, no caption, no nothing. I'll just leave it as it is. Just to show you the menu thing. Now you see that we have a menu with gallery 1 and gallery 2. And when I select gallery 2, it will show you the image that I've added there. Let's move back to gallery 1. So this is how the menu works there. Okay, what else? Okay, let me show you this item for this video, but not now. First, let's play a bit with the general settings. So right now the gallery, it's displayed in response, it is display type, it's responsive, which means that it will adapt based on the gallery maximum width, gallery maximum height, and also the space available. In this case, in this theme, there is not enough room to display the gallery at the sizes that are the width and height that I've specified here. Because of this, it looks smaller. You see, it's not 1200 pixels, it's smaller. But this, it's actually resized to keep a good ratio between these two numbers. So let's select the display type to fluid width. But not this one, our preset. Fluid width and update preset and refresh. Now you'll see the gallery is much, much larger than it was before. Okay, and now I can show you the video. So right now the default item width for the video is taken from the preset here. But if I go here to galleries, actually I have it open, and go to this video, I want to make it very, very small. For example, 400 pixels over 400 pixels. And now when I test this, you'll see that this video, it's the one with the, but it's very small compared to this one, which is taking the default values from the general setting. So this is how those two fields are working. Okay, what else to show you? There is also the full screen display if you want to use this one. It will show the gallery over the entire screen. Of course, you can choose which one to use based on your setup. Let's go to some of the settings here. So start at item and start at gallery. You can set which image and which gallery to show first. This is button. Let me show you the buttons alignment. So right now the buttons are displayed next to the image. To change this, there are three options. For example, out, and this will position the buttons here. See? And let me show you the top as well. Actually, I think let me show you. See, it's now they are positioned at the top. Okay, this is for slideshow. For example, slideshow autoplay to start the slideshow of the items, and you will notice this here. Now there's a cool thing about this slideshow. When I start the video, the slideshow, if you check here the while I start the video, it will actually be the same length of the video duration. See, this is very cool. And when it gets to the end, only then it's moving to the next one. So this is a nice trick here. A good thing to know. Let me set it to no. The other stuff is self-explanatory here. I'll not go through it. It's a waste of time for both of us. Just look at the name, and if you don't, for example, there is no point to add here a tooltip, because show full screen button, it's obvious. You can just yes or no, or show zoom button, yes or no. Let's move to the menu windows. By default, the menu is created by the galleries that are added in the galleries manager, but you can create an extra gallery with all the galleries in it. So if you have, for example, 5 galleries, if you set this to yes, it will create a gallery that has all the galleries inside. And this is the name. The name can be changed here. Let's set my all galleries. Of course, it's stupid. Okay, now when I refresh it and go here, you'll see that this is actually contains all my galleries, but the reason there are no thumbnails is because this one, and actually let me add the thumbnail here to see that it's working. I'll just add the same image even if it's larger. Please don't do this. I don't know which one it was, I think this one. Remember to save them at the correct size, or as I already explained it. Not sure why gallery 1, let me check this. Okay, gallery 2. It should have the should have. I think I forgot to. Yeah, I had to refresh it. So you see now there are all the two galleries that I've created, they are in one basically. So this is what it does. Also, if you want to, I think there is an option here. There is a randomized galleries. We can set to yes, and every time the page is refreshed, the user will see the images, the items randomized. So please check this here. Now if I refresh it, it's completely different, see? And they say the user can see every time it's opening the page a new item here. So this is nice if you want to use it. Go through all of these because there are a lot of nice features here. And just in case you have many galleries and you want to remove the menu, just set this to no. Now, you see there is no menu there. Let me enable it again. Let's go to the share window. So the share window, it's this one here, which allows to share the item. Here I've used the simple approach, just the names of the share platforms to share it. Let's remove some of them. Actually not, I'll just leave 3. Just delete the string and copy it, update the. And now you see that there are only 3 of them. And if you want to remove the button, the share button, just leave this empty. And now there is no share button. To get back the string there, you can just look here and remember and copy this. But an easier way, just go to the default one, copy everything, go back to your preset and paste it, update, and it's all set. Now this is the share URL type, deep link page or media, and other stuff, simple stuff here. The thumbnail settings represents the thumbnails at the bottom. Of course, the height can be different. I'll just set this to 200 pixels to see that the height will be higher. But of course, the images has to be set at this height to look okay, because now they are blurry. But it's good to keep a small size for the thumbnails because of the way the gallery is built and it's resizing. And also here, this is self-explanatory, no point to go into it. This is the caption. Let me go to an example that has a caption. I think it's the first one. And now you can just disable all caption by setting this to now, but I'll not show you this because it's obvious. Let me show you the position. So this is the top in. Right now the caption is positioned at outside of the bottom of the item. Now you'll see that it's positioned at the top, and also it can be positioned inside at the bottom. I already showed you how to style this stuff. Everything is in the CSS editor tab. Now if you are confused about the classes, just use the Google developer tool. So just click on this arrow and go to the element that you want to see, And if you look, I'll just click it, you will see here the class. See? FWDRMG title, and you can find this class inside the CSS editor. You can just edit as you want. In here again, the image description, it has this class. You can just search it in the CSS editor and modify it as you want. And this applies to all elements. So this is the description. Show caption on small screen, again self-explanatory. Animate caption, self-explanatory, and there are two types of in which the caption can be showed. Right now it's motion. Sorry, this one. So you will see that appears with the motion, and if I set it to opacity, motion with the animation basically from top to bottom or whatever, and now you'll see that it's using opacity. See? And let's move this to the bottom mount. See? And the last one is the video and audio player settings. Again, these are again self-explanatory. I'll just show you the autoplay, which is basic. I'm sure you'll use this. And I will just set it to yes. And now let's select a video. And I refresh the page, you'll see that the video autoplays, but in this case it's password protected, so let's choose this one. See, it's starting, of course, because of the autoplay policy, this button appears. You can also unmute it from this if you want. So, again, I will not go through all of this because everything is self-explanatory, it's a waste of time. So this is how it works, this is how the plugin works. One last thing that I want to show you is the... you can create, like I told you, you can create more than one gallery. You can add here a second gallery, gallery 2, I'm sorry. And now we have this gallery 2 and this one that we created. And in this gallery, you can add again as many things as you want. And when you go into the page and refresh it, you will find it here. And you can select the gallery and the shortcode will be updated. You see gallery 2 and gallery 1 if you change it. And also the preset as well, you can create as many presets as you want. Let's remove this gallery because it has to have something in it, otherwise the slider with the gallery will not work. And one last thing that I want to show you is the API. Now the API from the for the WordPress version works exactly the same as the JavaScript version. So there in the JavaScript version you'll find an extended explanation of all the options. These options can most of them can be modified at runtime, and also here there are some methods. There are not many, but they are useful, and events. Okay, and I'll show you quickly one of them. Let's go to, you can read this if you want to. Let's go here and you see here, for example, there is an event which is dispatched when the gallery, it's before the gallery it's showed. So basically when it's starting to show. And here it's a good place if you, for example, to modify all those options that I showed you. See these ones. All these options. Please note that not all of them are changeable at random. Those who that has this red star, they are can be modified, but most of them can be modified. The ones that are actually make sense to be modified at runtime, they are available. So let me go and just copy this here and go into the page. And again, this can be added in a JavaScript file. I will just add it here in a classic editor because it's easier. So what does this do? So it's first the gallery, it's listening from the onReady event, which is basically when the gallery is ready to be used. And then this is the instance name of the gallery, and it's adding an event which is this show start. And when this event is triggered, this function is executed. And this event also has two parameters, the gallery unique ID and the media identifier. So these are basically this stuff here. You can see in the link, you'll see that now we are at gallery zero, I'm sorry, and the item 2. See, now we are gallery 0, item 0, and now we are gallery 0 item 7, and before, based on this you can change stuff. For example, change the background color if this image is and I will show you this in a moment. And I have here a console, and if the gallery basically the condition here, when the if the a gallery ID is 0, which is the first gallery, I want to set the slash autoplay to true and use drag to false. And again, these options, if I copy this here and just search for it here, you will find it, you see, and you also find an explanation for it and how it's used, the type and all the stuff. So this is how it works. So let's update it and see if it's working. I didn't test this on WordPress version, but I think it will be fine. Let me see, something is not okay. So I forgot to add a script here, of course. So this is why it didn't work. Okay, let's test now. You see the event has triggered, and now the drag is disabled because, sorry, the slideshow is up. So what I've said here, slideshow autoplay, it's true, and if you check here, I'll just add a separate log to make it obvious. So this is a terrible editor for this, but whatever. Found gallery 1. So basically what I'm saying here, if the gallery it's the first one, I want to enable autoplay and also disable drag, okay? And now if you check the console, you see found gallery 1, the slideshow it's enabled, and I can also cannot drag this, okay? Now let's make a test for example for an item. So I will just grab this one to make sure I don't mess it up, and I will say again, this editor it sucks. If it's equal with 3, so if this is the fourth item in the gallery, I'm sorry about this, most likely you will not use it like this. I'll just want to show you how this works. I want to change the background color of this gallery to something else to show you how this works. Let me search for the background color here. Menu background color, background. Let's see if I can find something. Let's item background color and background color. So this is the main background color, it's an RGBA. So let's just copy it. And background color, and let's set this to a reddish one. So RGBA, and actually let's leave it red to be obvious here. RGBA, and I also need to set an alpha because it's an RGBA. And let's see if this works. So this is the fourth item, so this one doesn't work. Let's add some consoles here. Man, this is annoying. Something up here. You see the background is changed. I don't know what's happening here. But let's start with this one. Yeah, so this I'm confusing myself here. So this event is triggered when the gallery it showed. So this is why it didn't work. So now when I refresh the page, you see this is red. But I think we can. There is an event that can that it's dispatch when the. Let me see. So update item, this is the one that we want. So I'll just copy this here and paste it here. And I want to remove this slideshow and other stuff here. I'll just focus on this. Oh god, I don't know how to do this. Okay. Undefined. So yeah, I'm sorry, I'm confusing myself. So these options can only be changed when the gallery is showed, not when the item is updated, because it would be it will consume too many resources to do this on an item change. But this is working if I remove this to be easier to see. You see, I have a console here which is logging the gallery ID and the item ID. Now if I refresh this, you see now we are 03 and now 04, 05, and based on this you can do some type of logic there. The methods are used the same, are used via the gallery instance name, which is, you know what, let me show you this as well. Let's create here a button, click, and I'll just add mg0, which is the gallery instance name, and let's get a method from here, go to next item. Now this is a button. Of course, this can be used on any type of element. I've just added a button for simplicity, so that we do not waste too much time on this. So now if I refresh it, there is this button, and when I click it, you see it's going to the next item. So this is also done via the API, and also the event is triggered here. So this is how it works. I think I covered everything. If you have any questions or I don't know, suggestions about this gallery, please contact me on the email from the documentation that you can find here at the bottom, and let me know your thoughts. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and have a very, very good day. Bye bye.